One of the most common problems people have is they get stuck in the loop. They get stuck in that 4-bar, an 8-bar loop, 16-bar loop. They keep adding and adding, adding vertically. But what I want to do is show you how to do things, but horizontally. I want you to get out of the loop by using the loop function in Logic Pro. Let me show how I do it. Here's an 8-bar loop from a track of mine called Believe, featuring Cathy Diamond. So that's nice, but if I listen to this over and over and over and over, I will get really sick of it. And also, like, I will keep adding and adding and adding. And if you put everything that you see on screen right here in that 8-bar loop, it's going to sound very chaotic. And it's not a real way to make music, because, you know, making music is reacting to what you hear and, you know, on the moment as well, not just like adding stuff and then you're forced to sort of place it in your arrangement. So one thing that I use a lot is the loop function. So let's get out of that cycle, like pressing C. By pressing L, your track, your kick will go all the way to the end of your arrangement. So you want to remove that a little bit to where you think it's, you know, you want a 5-6 minute track or something like that, just as a guideline. I recommend doing that with every one of your tracks. For example, these are already looped. In order to get them to the end, you just have to drag them. You can highlight them all and drag them all the way to the end of your arrangement. Like this. What it then forces you to do is to act on a structure. Your structure will change, but it's good to start with something. So for example, with house music, often you start with the beats. So it's going to start, you know, maybe some keys as well, but you want like a mix-in for the DJ, so you're going to start with that. And as soon as you start the structure, you realize that it's not long before you're at like 3.5 minutes or 4 minutes, and now it's time to like start on the end of your song. So it's very encouraging. If you get stuck in that loop only lasts a few seconds, and it doesn't really show you that you can finish a song. Once I'm done looping everything I want all the way to the end, at least like the main parts, what I usually do is I do Control L on the tracks to change them into real copies and not just loops, so you can edit them separately and more easily go and cut through them. And again, you can highlight them all and do the same thing right here by pressing Control L.